Now we'll create a network and activities for the projects. So for that purpose, in the standard menu, we'll go to logistics, project system, and in the basic data, we will get for the standard network. So these are the transaction codes from the standard networks. So here we are initially we'll first of all we'll create the networks. So before going for the networks, we require the work centers also. We'll create a work center for the network. For the plant 3000 work center, we will create like US your ME01 and category will be for the product systems 6. This work center for independently for the process systems. So here we will give the description. Work center mechanical. Yes. So this is the work center category and person responsible for this work center. This is the customized setting we already made. So we use the person who is responsible and usage only for the networks, that will we'll select. This we have selected and we'll go to capacity screen. In the capacity category, we have to select whether for the person or a machine like that. So we are selecting labor. And we have to select the capacity category for scheduling also, that is also same. So this is the capacity header. So here again capacity planner group we need to give. Capacity planner group we have given factory calendar US. You can see the factory calendar for the our controlling area, that is US, and active version will be the normal one we are selecting, that is normal available capacity. Unit of measure will be hour. Then here we are giving the shift timings. We can say this is from 17 hours and 30 minutes lunch. Capacity utilization we require for 85% at least, number of capacity 5. Now for this is the capacity category again 2. We can check for the shift timing and shifting for capacities also. For the resources what we have selected, so we have selected 5 resources. So we'll see interval and shifts. Here we will add the interview you can say 2014 to 31st March. Will be 5 guys, but we are considering some resources shortage going to happen in the month of April, like this. This is the intervals we can make for the shift adjustments. So this should be 4. Again, this is the way to maintain the shifts and intervals. Now we have to maintain the formula. The formula for the, this is for the duration. Scheduling will be done based upon the duration. So this is the network and maintenance time, and in the capacities it will be based on requirement. So this is the formula for the requirements, and this is we have created for the work center mechanical. So we'll create one more work center for one more discipline. ESEL 01. We'll copy the same. So we are copying from the mechanical work center to electrical work center. So we'll take everything. Even we can copy the capacities and scheduling also. We are using the same, and the capacity US, and this is 01, this is hours, and these are the work hours, shift timings, and capacity utilization 85%, number of internal resources. If required, we can use the interval. Then we'll go to the scheduling part. This again 2, formula 4, and this is electrical save. So we have created the work centers for the network purpose. Now we'll create the network. As we already discussed, we can create the network in different ways, from the direct transaction or from the indirect transaction also. Now for creating the network, first of all we'll try with the direct transactions. that is CN21N. CN21 for the create network. So for creating the network, we have to keep in mind that always this network and activities will be created for the purpose of resources, assigning the resources and planning the resources, and these resources will be used against a project. So whenever we create a network, we have to keep in mind that we are creating the networks against a project. So this network numbering we have to keep with relevance to a project. So we need to see any existing project. From the existing project, the profile and network numbering, if we keep similar, it will be helpful for searching the network or assigning the network like that. So now in the first screen, while assigning the network numbering, we'll do in the similar way. So here we'll select the network profile what we have created for the plan 3000 and network type PS1. So we'll select network type PS1, and MRP controller we can consider from the existing mapped and MRP controller. Now if you press enter, system will ask us immediately the network number we have to assign externally, because we have selected the number range as external assignment. So we have to mention the network number external assignment. If we consider it, we would have been considered as an internal assignment, then system will automatically allocate the network number. Now we have to give the number starting with the N. We are given the number range in such a way, then U, after that the numbers. These numbers we will simulate with the projects what we have created. Now we'll see the existing project from CJ20N. So these are the some projects we have created. So we'll consider any one project to map to this. To map to existing project, we will create the network for different WBS, second level WBS elements. So normally for the existing project U3000.1401, in this project we'll see how many second level WBS we have selected. So here we can see the WBS elements we have selected. Second level WBS element, this is one for the civil, one for the equipment, and one for the preoperative. So we'll create the network for second level WBS elements only, and we'll assign the WBS elements to second level WBS elements. System will not restrict to assign a network any place, but logically the number of network activities will be restricted to a particular number. If we have the individual resource planning by WBS level wise, it will be better. So all the time it is better to create a network against a second level WBS element. Otherwise, if we feel we will be having very lesser activities, so we'll have only one network and which will be assigned at a level 1. And the next point is, whenever we are creating a network at a second level WBS element, that should be account assignment enabled, otherwise system will not allow to assign a WBS element to a network header. Now first of all, we will create the network for this particular project. So here we are using 3000.1401C. So here we will take it out the dot and we'll keep C. So this will, or we can in the C like this. Now continue. That means we are creating here the network for the purpose of project U3000.1401C, and it is asking the scheduling type. We haven't done the scheduling parameter, so at the moment we will give the scheduling type. After that we can change if required, and start date we need to give. We can consider the start date from this. So we can say the activities will last long until 31st July. So this dates we have assigned. Start date is in the past. The information has been given. Now we can see directly system has been taken the status, system status like created, material availability has been not done, dates are not scheduled. These are the default statuses system will take. Now we have to give the network description. So we can say network for civil. So we are not assigning at the moment the WBS elements, business area and all. We can consider object class for the investment. Now if you go to the control, we can see that details are has been defaulted from the network profile. So this is the network header we are created. Activity, account assignment, created, material availability not checked, dates are not updated. These are the status and created status. Now we can save this network, or we can create activities for the network. So these are the some tools are available. This is for the scheduling. This is for the calculate cost. This is material availability check. This is the hierarchy of the network, and this is the network entire network graphical representation. And this is the Gantt chart, activities, material overview, and this is project version, and this is object overview. So now we'll create some activities for this network. So in this particular project we have to segregate the network activities for this particular civil WBS element like that. So now we can say foundation piling and bricking, plastering and some cleaning jobs. So and we have to tell about normal duration also, how many days it may take, such thing. This we can say 90 days, this is 45 days, this is 30 days, 45 days. For the temporary purpose we are given this. Now we have to give the work center over here. We have created a work center for the project. So we use the mechanical work center over here. So we are assigning the work center. And since we have considered the automatic calculation of the work, now we are given the duration, and to calculate the work the number is required, how many resources are being used for this particular work. Now this automatically work has been calculated based upon the number, considering as resource as 1. If required, we can change these resources, how many resources we are going to use. Now we are considered these are the resources, so automatically the numbers, this work also will be automatically changed. Now we are doing this is for the internal processing purpose. The planning part will come afterwards. Now we are only creating the network and the activities, so the planning part will take later. So now we have created one network. Now we have said we have created a network header and we have created network activities also. Now the next step is, once we created the network, we have to assign the network to a WBS element or a project. So then only the resource planning will be utilized against a WBS element. Now this project has been created. Now we can see the network what we have created. We'll go to the header information. This is a network header we have created. The assignments. Here we have to mention the WS element or a project definition for which we are assigning this network. So we are entering the WS element. So from the WS element, system will automatically should fetch the project definition automatic from the hierarchy. So dates will be copied from the, now you can see your project definition has been copied. Control administration long test, nothing is there. Now we'll go and see the activities what we have created. These are the activities we have created. Save. Now we have assigned the WBS element. So this is the way to create the network with the activities from the direct transaction method. We'll see the one more indirect method to create the network. Another way is, we'll use the same profile. Now the network what we have created we'll use as a template. Existing networks also can be used as templates to create new network. Now again system will ask, what is the next network we are going to create? So we are using row 1, this time we are creating E. Continue, then automatically the settings, all the settings will be copied from the existing network, and if required we can change the details of the network what we are creating. So here we are copying network from the existing network. So here the message it is giving old 8/30/9/2000. 14. We will go to assignments. Here we have to assign the WBS element. This is 1000 1401. So this is the WBS element we have assigned. Automatically system derives the project definition from the hierarchy. Now remaining settings also copied from the profile. Now we can see the activities what are copied from there. So if required, we can keep the activities if are similar. Otherwise, we can change the activities. We take one by one. So now automatically the work will be recalculated. So now we can save this. So now we have created a network from the existing network. This is one more method to create the network with the help of existing network. Now we'll see the other method to create a network are indirectly method instead of direct method. So we have used CN21 to create for the both the purposes. Now if you go to the project builder, from the project builder also we can create the network. First of all, we see whatever we have created the network, whether these are how these are appearing in the project builder. We have created two networks, one for the civil header and one for the equipments header. So here we have created one network and here one more network we have created, and these are the all activities are there. Now here one thing, in the existing project the networks has been created, we have to assign the WBS elements for the network activities also. We have assigned the WBS element for the network header. Now we will assign the WBS element for network activities. Now we'll see how we'll assign the WBS elements. Now we can see here how to in this project. Here these are the activities. So this activity foundation we can say will be by dragging the system will display a message if any issue is there. This is system is not allowing to assign the WBS element just because of this account assignment check is not assigned. So now we'll go and see for how many WBS elements account assignment check is kept. Now we can see the this WBS element has been kept as account assignment, and this one here, and at the fourth level, the third level, the account assignment has been not kept. So whenever we need to assign a WBS element, we need to ensure that that is having the account assignment indicator. So this fourth level is having, that is the reason why system is allowing us to assign the WBS element to a activity. So here this way we are assigning the activity. So one WBS element we can keep more than one activity also, it is possible. Now we have created and we have assigned the WBS elements to activities. Similar way, here also we have some more activities. These activities also this means it is doesn't have R. If and go and keep the account assignment element check for all the WBS elements if required. So we are allowing at the other level if required to be account assignment need to be network activity need to be assigned, then it is mandatorily required to assign. So we are shifting here. Assembling So whenever we create the activities, we have to do logical way so that we can use them whenever it is required. Now we have created the network with the activities and we assign the WBS elements. We can assign the WBS elements in the network direct transaction also, or in the project header also we can assign the activities with the WBS elements. Now we'll see how to create a network from the project builder. Now we'll see the from the existing project after assigning all the activities to the networks how it looks like in a planning board, how the planning board looks like after assigning the activities to WBS elements. We can see the planning board here, the separate color which is indicating the activities which are assigned over here. if we select all the entire project with all the WBS elements, how it look like, so you can see. So this is the entire project with the elements. This is a project builder we are having. Now we'll see how to create a network. We are taking this project, other project we have taken. Now we will create the network for civil and equipment directly in the project builder. So we'll go to the templates, individual objects, select the network and simply putting over here. Now system will we are creating a network and assigning directly to civil. Now here we have to mention the description, network for civil automatically, and all the details has been taken from that WBS element. Now we need to give the numbering for the network. So but directly dragging into network object into the WBS, automatic creation of the network and assigning to the WBS will take place. Now similarly, we can create the activity also, internal processing activity. This is so it is asking about the number assignment for the network number. Or we can save the existing network. System will assume that we are creating the activity for the existing against an existing network. So we need not to go for a new network. So we'll going for individual objects, activity, internal processing. Now we'll create a activity directly to a WBS element, NU3 14.02E. Here we are creating an activity to a WBS element for which we haven't assigned a network. We have assigned the network to civil and we are trying to create whenever we are creating a activity, automatically system will create one network also along with the activity. So this is one more advantage we are having in the project builder. Without creating the network header, we are creating a activity, system will automatically creates a network header also by assigning the same network. So here we can reassign the WBS element if required for a network. So here this network is been assigned to civil WBS element. So we can take back to equipment, and the activity also we can reassign to some other WS element. So here we would like to create a internal activity here we are giving So now we'll create one more network header from the existing. So we'll see how to create a network. Copy network, copy from U T02C. Object selection, what are we are need to we required everything, and parameters also require the same. Copy. Now it asks what is the name for the new network number. We have to mention for the new network. So network here we have created one. You can see the activities. Activities we are not selected for the copy. So if required we can reassign this to civil. So here we have created the network from project builder by copying from other network. Now we'll try to create one more network from copying from other network. So we have already create one network. This is for E. Now we'll relocate this. Then we'll create a one network by copying from other network. This is for the creation directly and copy network. Here we'll use the other network we'll select all, and the profile we'll select the new one what we have created. This is the network number we are entering. 3C continue. This is the working for C. So this is network we have created. If we want to, this is a network we have created. Now we'll create one network template from the existing network, and we'll use the same for network creation at other places. For that purpose, we need to go to logistics, process system, and basic data. Templates, standard network, create. Here we'll use the profile, standard profile we can use. And we have to give the standard network number. If it is a internal numbering, directly system takes the number, or we can create new profiles, standard network. Created if we want, we can create the activities for the same. So here we have created the activities, and we haven't assigned any number range profile as actional. So system will generate one internal number for the standard network. So this template we can use for creating new networks. So we'll see over here. Standard network what we have created. This we have created the standard network, and this is the header for that network. So this is the way to create the standard network, and we can use the same profile, same template for creating new networks. Now we can copy from existing to create new one also, and there is a provision to delete the template. And similarly, like WBS templates, here also the standard network template should be released for the use. So we are keeping a deletion flag for deleting the network template. So selecting the task, continue, we will delete the, it will delete the standard network. You can see here, this is task list has been reorganized and there is a detail network. Now there is a way to create the network in different methods, directly or from the project builder, copying from the existing, creating the new one. In various ways we have created the network with the activities. This is about network with the activities creation.